Hello, yes, welcome back after a while. I'm alive, but I have a tier list of all the weapons I've used, and this is all my opinion. I'm not ranking them based on how good they are, how much damage they do. I'm ranking them based off of my opinion. These are all the weapons I've used in the Souls series. At least I think. I'm like 99% sure. There may be a couple that I left out, but whatever. This is my opinion as well. So, if you say, no, the Pimp Cane doesn't belong in S tier, I say, screw you. It's my video. It's me. Anyway, let's get on to it. First off, I'm gonna go with the Zvi from Dark Souls 1. Now, I really liked the Zvi, and I love the Zvi. It's one of my favorite weapons. But after I tried replaying through Dark Souls 1 a while ago, tried using the Zvi, and I was like, this is hard. But I can't say that I didn't enjoy using it, because I love the Zvi. It's one of my favorite weapons. I'm putting it in A tier. Next, I'm going to pick... let's go with the Hunter's Axe from Bloodborne. Now, this was the first weapon I used in Bloodborne. I loved playing Bloodborne. Fantastic game. And the Hunter's Axe, I really, really liked using. It was fantastic. It was amazing. And, like, it was versatile. It was just fun. I liked using it. Then the Halberd version was fun to use. It felt like a good version of the Black Knight Halberd. I'll get to you later. But, yeah. Good weapon. S tier. I loved using it. Next, I'm gonna go with Longsword from Dark Souls 3. Now, I really liked it. It's solid. It's good. I really can't think of anything bad about it, but it's also kinda not much to write home about. It's not bad, but eh. I'm going to say solid C tier. Next, the Cestus. Hated these. They may be fast, they may be spammy, but they do no damage and they have no range. I hated playing it. I hated playing with these. Getting through Farron Keep was a nightmare. I hated these. F tier. Next, I'm going to go with the Uchi Katana from Dark Souls 1. And while yes, I personally... it wasn't my cup of tea. It's definitely good. It's useful. It's just not me. I'm saying B. For boy, that's not my thing. Next, I'm going to go with Irithyll Straight Sword. Honestly, it seems good on paper, but I don't know where Titanite or Twinkling Titanite stuff is in Dark Souls 1, so C. It's fine. I just don't care for it. Next, I'm going to do... let's go with the Sellsword Twin Blades. I liked using the Twin Blades when I first used them, but when I went back and played the game through with the Great Scythe, I had to use the Twin Blades for a little bit, and boy howdy, they are not satisfying. Everything about them, it's just... they're too spammy, they do too much damage, they're not good. D tier for dumb. Next, Craftsman's Hammer. Basically the only weapon I've used in Dark Souls 2. It's really good, however, it's too good for what it is. Granted this is Dark Souls 2 prom, Dark Souls 2 is not bad, it's good, but like... It's more just a Dark Souls 2 problem where strike damage is so good, so it's better than it really is. It really doesn't feel like it should be doing this good damage, but really good, just not satisfying. B. Next, I'm going to go Longsword, Dark Souls 1. Violently mediocre. It's very just, this is the first weapon you get, you're gonna get better ones, B don't stick with this. It's bad. Anyway, D tier for dog. There are better weapons. Next, I'm going to go with the Claymore from Dark Souls 1. I haven't used the Claymore in Dark Souls 3 just because, honestly, the Claymore, it's really good. It's a really good just vanilla weapon. It does a lot of damage, and it's still pretty fast. Like I was using it in my playthrough before I got the Black Knight Halberd, and I was having a really good time with it. This is a really good vanilla option. It does damage, but you're not so slow that you're basically a sitting duck. And it's also quality. Anyway, S tier. Next, I'm gonna go with the Kirk Hammer. I used it for a bit. I got stuck on Bloodstarved Beast. C tier. It's fine. Nah. Next, I'm going to go with this Vi Dark Souls 3. I honestly can't remember much about it, except it was really slow. And, like, there were times where I was like, ugh. And I also did it, like, right after I finished Dark Souls 1 for the first time. And I was like, oh, Dark Souls 3 is better. And, so yeah. B tier, not bad. Saw Cleaver. Please don't crucify me for this, but the Saw Cleaver just isn't my cup of tea. It's not bad. Don't get me wrong. It's not bad. It's not bad at all. However, I just... Yeah, it's just not my cup of tea. I didn't enjoy using it. It's fun. It's fine. It's not me. It's not me. C tier. Next. The Pimp Cane. No, I'm not gonna lie. I'm not gonna lie. This weapon, definitely not as good as the Hunter's Axe. I'm not arguing that. But I legitimately had fun with it. Now, at the start, Pimp Cane, no, it's terrible. But here's the thing about the Pimp Cane. It's a skill weapon, and visceral attacks in Bloodborne scale with skill, and parrying in Bloodborne is basically vital to it. In Dark Souls 1, 2, and 3, parrying, take it or leave it. Meanwhile, in Bloodborne, you kind of have to, so a high skill means that you get ridiculously high visceral attacks. Like at the end of the game, when I was fighting Garmin, like, I was getting either 2,000 damage visceral attacks or 2,300. I can't remember for the life of me. I was doing a lot of damage. This is going to be my controversial one. A tier. I really liked using it. It was fun. And the whip version, I will 100% admit, it's not useful. It's rarely useful. It's not good. But there are the small occasions where having the whip is good, because you can be a few paces back. You got some range between you and the bad man. It's just that the whip is kind of bad. But just use the cane version of it. There. Next, the Bastard Sword, Dark Souls 3. I love this weapon. It's so good. It's so fun. I loved it so much. Because it does damage. I like doing a lot of damage in one swing, and the Bastard Sword is that. And it also just has a funny name. I love it. Because it's funny. Oh, take this, you bastard. I'm going to hit you with my Bastard Sword. And I like it. It's fun. It does damage. I like it. Next, the Dark Sword. I like this weapon. Haven't used it in a while. But I liked it just because it looked cool. That was about 99% of it. So, yeah. It's good. I liked it. Next, the Great Scythe. I kind of like this weapon. Mostly because it's a dex weapon, but it feels more like a strength weapon. I like that. It was fun. I could two-hand it, and I like two-handed weapons in Dark Souls 3. It's a fun weapon, and also, like, hitting the sweet spot, it always felt fun, because the other fun thing is it pierces shield, so the Twin Princes are actually easier for me. A tier. Next weapon. I'm going to save the worst for last. Demon Fists. The Demon Fists are everything that the Cestus aren't. The Cestus, I hate them because they do no damage. The Demon Fists, they do damage. And you got like 100 bonus fire damage, so I really like them. And, like, this was the weapon that I beat Sister Freed with. Let me tell you, that boss was not easy. But I was able to beat the game with them, so S tier. I really liked it. S for super cool. Now for you. Now I'll admit, the Black Knight Halberd at the start of the game, when I first got it, it was actually pretty solid. Mostly just because it had really good scaling at the start. And it did pretty good damage once you hit that cap, the weapon, it just plummets into mediocrity. Like, normally, I can beat Ornstein and Smough pretty easily. I like Ornstein and Smough. It's a fun fight. But that's because I have a weapon that does stagger. The Black Knight Halberd doesn't do stagger. It does nothing. And like, once I hit the cap, it just gone. Completely. The damage it did was good, but it stopped scaling, so it wasn't good. Like, technically, if you max it out, it does more damage than the other Black Knight weapons. However, the cap, it drops off so fast that it's just nothing. It's nothing. And don't even get me started on the moveset. The moveset is so bad. One-handing it is terrible because it's so slow. It's so slow. And the kind of moves that you'd want from a halberd kind of weapon would be, you know, a poke and a sweep. That's not what you get with a Black Knight Halberd. The light attack is like some sort of dumb slam, overhead slam. That's not what I want. And like, the heavy attack is useless. I hated it so much. And then the heavy attack, or did I say heavy attack? I can't remember. A heavy attack, beyond useless. Terrible. Hated it. And then, like, I was trying to beat the game with it. I got to Tomb of the Giants. And once I got there, I died a couple times, and I was having a terrible time. Because the Black Knight Halberd is bad. It's not fun to use. Its moveset is slow. It doesn't do enough stagger for the slow to be good. That's the thing that makes the Zwei so good. The Zwei does stagger. You hit someone, even if they're in the middle of hitting you, guess what? They're no longer able to hit you because you did so much damage in one hit. They're staggered. Black Knight Halberd, it doesn't have that. It doesn't have anything. It's slow. It's clunky. It's everything that the Zwei is and less. And guess what? Guess what? Guess what? My fully upgraded Zwei did more damage than my fully upgraded Black Knight Halberd. I did not enjoy using this weapon. If there was a tier less than F, I would put it there. But because I can't, that's where it goes. Thank you for watching this video. Subscribe, follow me on Twitter. I post mild bangers every now and again. Goodbye. Love you.